Pensions will please come to order. This morning, we're holding a hearing entitled "The Implementation of the 21st Century Cures Act Responding to Mental Health Needs." Senators Cassidy and Murphy were the leaders in this committee on mental health reform and in the Senate. And those reforms were included in our 21st Century Cures Act. Senator Murray is not here today, and so she's asked Senator Murphy to fill in for her. And I've asked Senator Cassidy to chair most of this hearing, or at least until 11:45. I'll come back and attend it, but I think it's appropriate that Senators Cassidy and Murphy chair the hearings, especially given their extensive work in the area and their leadership in enacting the legislation last year. After our witness testifies, senators will have 5 minutes of questions. Sean Lester is, by all accounts, a typical busy Nashville young adult with a full-time job who also attends college. In June 2014, 2 days before his 25th birthday, he experienced his first schizophrenic experience. Since then, Sean has been admitted to the Vanderbilt Psychiatric Hospital 5 times, spending 10 weeks receiving psychiatric treatment. Sean recently wrote me saying, "This may seem slightly depressing, but my story does not end there. The doctors and staff I encountered at the hospital and at the Centerstone Clinic taught me to live productively again in society. I've been free of the hospital for a whole year now. During that time, I've taken medication, returned to work, and even paid off a car. I'm currently enrolled at Tennessee State University as a junior pursuing a degree in psychology." Sean is one person out of nearly 10 million in the United States with a serious mental health condition. Without this treatment, his story could have had a very different outcome. In Tennessee, about 1 in 5 adults have a mental illness, according to the Tennessee Department of Mental Health and Substance Abuse. That is more than 1 million Tennesseans. And over 230,000 of them have what is considered a serious mental illness. Over the past few years, this committee has worked in a bipartisan way to update parts of the federal mental health system, including programs at the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Services Administration, which we call SAMHSA, for the first time in over a decade. As I said at the beginning, this effort was championed by Senators Cassidy and Murphy, as well as Senator Collins and other members of this committee. The reforms are part of the Mental Health Reform Act, which passed this committee on March 16 of 2016, and were included in the 21st Century Cures Act, which Majority Leader McConnell called the most important legislation Congress passed last year. Today marks the third hearing on the implementation of the Cures legislation. We hope the updates in this law will help more Americans access quality, evidence-based mental health care. As I said when we began hearings on the Every Student Succeeds Act, a law is not worth the paper it's printed on if it's not implemented properly. And I intend to ensure that the 21st Century Cures Act is fully and properly implemented as well. Our focus today is to hear how SAMHSA is implementing the mental health provisions in Cures. Of the 10 million Americans with a serious mental health illness, and that includes severe schizophrenia, bipolar disorder, major depression, millions go without treatment as families struggle to find care for loved ones. Most of the services and treatments for people with mental illness are provided by the private sector, such as Vanderbilt, or through programs run by the states. The largest role in the federal government is the amount of money spent through Medicaid in partnership with the states. The federal government also plays a role through SAMHSA, which, while relatively small compared to Medicaid and the responsibilities states have, is critically important to improving the availability and quality of prevention screenings, early intervention and treatment programs, and recovery services. Tennessee received over $80 million in SAMHSA grants last year. Prior to our work on Cures, federal mental health programs had not been updated in over a decade, and the coordination between federal agencies was not as effective as it could have been. I hope today we'll learn more about how implementation of those provisions is going. How has coordination improved among federal agencies on the best way to assist those with mental illness? For example, we hope that promising research into early intervention programs at the National Institutes of Health would translate into clinical applications for patients. We also included updates to the SAMHSA block grants to states to ensure the funding is best meeting the needs of those suffering from mental illness. In addition, to improve the care patients receive, we encourage the adoption of proven scientific approaches to treatment. So I'd like also to hear how the agency started to incorporate more evidence-based approaches for treating mental health. We also hope the reforms would help increase integration between primary care and mental health care, ensure that insurance coverage for mental health disorders is comparable to insurance coverage for other medical conditions, and strengthen suicide prevention efforts. Dr. McCants Katz, our witness today, serves as the first Assistant Secretary for Mental Health and Substance Abuse, a position we created in the 21st Century Cures Act. She has new authorities through Cures to work with states and federal agencies and help more Americans receive the treatment they need. I look forward to hearing about the progress being made to ensure more people can receive the help they need and have positive outcomes like Sean. I'd now like to turn the chairing of this hearing over to Senator Cassidy, and Senator Murphy will make an opening statement, then Senator Cassidy will make a statement, and then Senator Cassidy, you can take it from there. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Chairman Alex.